For RCR Wireless News, I'm Sean Kinney, and we're here on the Dell Technologies Stand at Mobile World Congress in Barcelona to talk with Dell and KPN about the collaboration you have to really enable Industry 4.0 for smart manufacturing. But before we get into that conversation, could you both briefly introduce yourselves for our audience, please?
Yes, Hilde Ekstrijs, Dell EMEA line of business.
Paul Coven, KPN, portfolio lead for KPN Campus.
Okay, so this idea of bringing connectivity and commute to enterprises at their locations been around for a while, seen as a growth area for operators, but it's been a little bit of slow going. So to start off, maybe you can both share some perspective on the big opportunities here, but also the big challenges that we need to work through to kind of really see that material revenue lift. Jan, can we start with you?
Yes, absolutely. So from a Dell perspective, we have seen indeed manufacturing 4.0 being a key challenge, but also key opportunity. I think indeed where we are looking at bringing IoT, AI, and Edge together, it does bring a lot in the view of operational efficiency, productivity gains, innovation. However, the challenge is really on connecting all these different elements together and what do you really get from it? Because everybody that we're speaking to customers, it's all about what do I get for the investment that I'm making? And how do I start? Where do I start? And which parties do I need to bring to the table? Because it is a play of bringing parties to the table and building an ecosystem.
Yeah, Paul, what's your perspective on that?
I think starting with the 5G part, I think looking at the public side, the public 5G, we in the Netherlands are getting ready to roll out the 3.5 gigahertz spectrum. And that will enable a lot of new possibilities for the whole of the Netherlands. And the other thing is that 14 months ago, the government also issued the possibility to acquire private spectrum. And that, I think, is also a boost for the whole industry 4.0, giving the companies the possibility to acquire their own spectrum and have more possibilities with the 5G technology in the factories. I think that is a key enabler to have growth on this domain, especially in the Netherlands, where I am active.
And to help kind of contextualize that for us, I visited the GSMA stand earlier and checked out KPN's demo, but could you maybe describe for us what's on display there?
Yeah, what we do, we have a production line in Eindhoven at the high-tech region of the Netherlands. I brought one of the production elements here, so it's like a machine. And what we do, we build a private network, and that is connected to the OT side of the machine. So it's a PLC. That's called the PLC, and that PLC is connected to the 5G network. But that's the first step. What you said, it's combining technology. So the other thing is, if you want to do something on Industry 4.0 or digital factories, you need to also address how you work with software. So one of the ways that we are approaching that is using a whole different method of developing software based on low code and behavioral models, like we call them. And what we essentially do, we take out all the logic that is in the machine, often in embedded software or on PLCs with old kind of software methodologies, and we push it out as virtualized logic onto the Dell Edge server. That's what we do. And in that way, we can run really critical production applications on the Dell Edge server, and we have a trustworthy connection with the private 5G network. So that's essentially one of the things that we want to combine. The whole logic centralization and a trustworthy 5G network.
Okay, and Hian, maybe you can highlight for us what Dell is bringing to this solution in terms of infrastructure and edge orchestration. And I guess what I'm really trying to understand is, does an end user, in this case in a manufacturing vertical, do they need to onboard new types of skill sets to use this, or is the idea to just make it easy to consume so they focus on their core business?
That is exactly it. So from a Dell perspective, we are bringing native edge in the solution, and that is Dell's secure, automated, multi-cloud operations software platform. And in that way, it is technology, but it's hidden in a way for the customer, because ultimately for the customer, it's about being able to access services, applications, solutions in the manufacturing that are going to drive operations, processes, or security safety. But from a Dell perspective, working with KPN, we are trying to literally offer it as a service to the manufacturers. So what's happening behind and what is needed technology-wise to get the elements in the factory ready, to get the platform ready, to be able to centrally be managed and scaled and being able to deliver the software and the solutions to those manufacturers is something that's hidden. So that is where knowledge gaps and skills gap is not an issue from an enterprise perspective.
Yeah, fits really well with the topology that the network part of the service is about, which is also kind of a centralized management portal that manages all the decentral elements at the customer side. So that's I think that is a good way to also access all this telecom knowledge and give it to the customer and make it easy for him or her to use that technology there. I think that's really relevant.
Well, I think more to this point around ease of use, and obviously AI, a big theme at the show, but in the demo, this idea of conversational AI where you can use natural language to communicate with a machine or an industrial asset, I mean, this is very significant. So,
yes.
Paul, I'm curious if you can maybe give us some insight into how you see that type of paradigm gaining traction in manufacturing environments and how we should think about that over time.
Yeah, what I said, when you look at manufacturing, the whole PLC programming, old-fashioned, inaccessible, machines often are also for the user in the factory a black box. So you need to change that. You need to make it open, you make the data accessible. If you look at what we do with the Edge server, the first thing we do, we have an environment where we collect all the data from the machine. And then we use these behavioral models to to tap into that and visualize what the machine is actually doing. So you can really see what part is moving in a state diagram, how it is flowing. And then what we added a few months ago is the large language model for manufacturing. And this model is now able to access the data, access those models, and really show you what the machine is doing, but also learning. So there is a digital twin of the machine, and this LLM can iterate with that digital twin. And he can think about improving his own process. You can also ask him questions, when do you need maintenance? So the whole predictive maintenance is much more granular than when you would use external sensors for that. You really get the data from in the machine, the live data. And that is what you are using to do predictive maintenance on all other kinds of processes. So you tap into kind of a real-time environment where you can ask, what are you doing? How can you improve? What can I learn? How do we need to adapt to a changing production request that is coming in? All these things are becoming possible. Yeah, that's, I think, the revolution. Yeah.
I think it's a matter of being able to leverage and use the interfaces, the information, the data that comes to them. That is more important than really technically understanding what's happening behind and under the covers.
And so I know we focused our conversation today on manufacturing environments, but maybe we could get some summary thoughts from each of you on applicability of this solution to other vertical industries and how you plan to continue working together to really drive digital transformation more broadly.
It's interesting because when you look at the concept of a behavioral model, you can apply it to a manufacturing environment, but you can also apply it to a HVAC system that is in a building. So one of the things that we are now doing is seeing how can we, that general infrastructure that is in each building, the behavior of that, we can describe it. And then you can apply it in healthcare, or you can apply it in a logistics center. You can do so many things with it, but the next that we will focus on is healthcare, definitely, because there is a lot of traction for that.
Yeah, what we did with KPN is actually part of Dell's approach on how we are partnering with telcos in going to market and meet enterprise customers' needs for solutions and managed services. So when we started with KPN, we sat down and we established where do we want to go to market together and which customers do we need to service with what kind of solution. But looking into what we then prioritize, looking at smart manufacturing, underneath the blueprint of the technology that's used is something that could function pretty much for any customer with the characteristics of needing the ability to deliver solutions and applications to multiple locations, where the telco will be managing it centrally on their behalf and deliver indeed data to the customer so that they can take the appropriate decisions at the right time. So from a smart manufacturing perspective, elements like the predictive maintenance or safety, security, or visual inspecting things, it is retail, it's utilities, it is healthcare. It could be replicated relatively easily across multiple verticals. But for our partnership, I think it is important that we establish where do we want to start and how do we grow that business by prioritizing and focusing.
Well, it's a really compelling solution and a really important partnership. So I appreciate you both taking the time to share your perspectives with our audience.
Thank you.
You're very welcome.